Hello, dear students. I am Dr. Sanjeev Pagar, Associate Professor, Department of Geography. Dear students, I welcome all of you in this online video lecture series on behalf of Maratha Vidya Prasarak Samajas, KRPRs, BH Commerce, and AM Science, popularly known as KTCM College, Nasik. Dear students, this is our MA-MSc Part 1st, Semester 1st class, and in this class, we are going to discuss our paper. The code of our paper is GGUT113. The title of our course is Principles of Economic Geography. Today we are going to discuss our last subtopic of our chapter number 2, that is economic activity. And today we are going to discuss a very important subtopic of the chapter, that is Van Thuynen's model. Dear student, in last lecture we discussed about Weber's model about industry location. Today we will be talking about the Van Thuynen's model of agriculture land use. Dear student, before talking more about Van Thuynen's model, let's talk little bit about Van Thuynen. Van Thuynen was a farmer and unprofessional economist. The Van Thuynen's model was first time he proposed by Van Thuynen in his book. The title of that book was The Isolated State, and it was published in 1826. Dear student, the Van Thuynen was a farmer, and whatever information he explained in this model, that all information he explained with his own experience of the 40 years. He was a farmer, and he carried out the farming activity in Germany on the basis of his own experience and the statistical data. He stated this model. Dear student, it compared the relationship between production cost, the market price, and the transport cost of an agriculture commodity, showing how and why agricultural land use varies with the distance from the market. Dear student, while studying this model, we need to consider certain assumptions which are made by Van Thuynen. We will discuss all of them one by one. Let us see the first assumption. There is an isolated state consisting of one market city and its agriculture land use. Means when we apply this model, that time that area should be like a isolated state and it has one marketplace. The second assumption is there is a homogeneous physical environment including a uniform plain around the city. That is very important. Homogeneous means with respect to the climate, with respect to the physiography and all other physical environment. It should be the equal everywhere. And one thing is there, that should be the uniform plain around the city. That is very important. The third assumption is there is a only one mode of transportation, and it is the horse and the wagon. That is very important. Next one assumption is this city is the market for surplus products from the hinterland and the receive products from no other area. That is very should means whatever the agriculture commodity or the crops, that should be the produce inside that hinterland, inside that isolated state. There should not be the outside source or outside commodity bring or brought in that area. So that is very important. Otherwise, this model will not be the applicable for other area. Next one is the all labor cost were equal everywhere in the region. Means inside that isolated state, everywhere the labor cost should be equal. The next one, next assumption is the hinterland shift its surplus to no other market except this city. That is very important. Next assumption is the hinterland is inhabited by farmer who wish to maximize their profit. That is very, very important, because each and every farmer should be try to maximize his profit through the agriculture activity and the production. The transportation costs are directly proportional to distance, and it should be a same everywhere at any direction. Means we are talking about the Van Thuynen was talking about the when we travel any part of that that particular isolated area, then there should be the rate of or the cost of transport is equal in each and every direction. That is very important. Otherwise, we are not going to apply this model, this Vandana's model, for the reason. Dear student, one is very important. The when he discussed his model that time, he introduced very important concept, the concept of economic rent or the location rate. On the basis of this this concept, he explained his model. As the measure of level of return that the market would be expect a particular price of a land to produce. So that about the economical rent, or it is also known as the location rate. Dear student, means this concept, this rent is totally depend on the market price, production cost and transport cost. By considering the three costs, he calculate the economical rent for that particular area. And for that purpose, he used the formula, very important formula. The formula is given by the Vantunan is LR is equal to Y into bracket M minus C minus TD. And the long cut of this detail about this value, he explained here, where LR, that is LR here, is equal to location rent. Y stand for yield per unit of land. M stand for market price per unit. Here we are talking about the agriculture commodity. Then we have the C. C is equal to production cost per unit. Then we have T. T means transportation cost per unit. And D stand for distance from the market, means that city market. So on the basis of this value, he calculated the economical rent, or you can say the locational rate. On the basis of this rent, he explained his theory in detail. Dear student, the one thing is also important. In this theory or in this model, two themes are very important. The first theme is that intensity of the theory or intensity of that model. You know that, student, the intensity of the production of particular crops will decline with the distance from the market. It means when we move from the center of the from market to any direction, that time when the distance will be increased from the market, that time the intensity will going to decrease. So that is very important theme he explained in his model. Land use intensity decline with the distance from the market means both things are very important. The intensity of particular crops is important. That also going to increase when we move from away from the city. And same thing about the land use intensity. The land intensity is also declined with we move from the center of the city toward the away or the toward any direction from the city. Then definitely that intensity of the land use will be declined. And one important thing is more intensive farming activity tend to locate near the market. That is very important principle, very important theme he explained in his model. The farming activity tend to locate far away from the market. That is very important. And next theme is crop theory or crops model. Dear student, the type of land use will be vary with the distance from the market. It means very simple. When you move from the away from the market, then definitely in that region, you will observe that land use is also going to change from distant to distant. So when we move from the city area toward the other part of the that isolated state, that type, you will observe that the density of the crops will also going to decrease. It means that the intensity of the crops is not same everywhere. That was explained by the Vantunan in his model. The crops with the highest economic rent will be grown near the city. That is very important. And this concept applies to any location that was explained by the model, Vantunan in his model. Dear student, let us see what type of the land use zone you will observe around the city area, around the market area as per the Vantunan's model. Let us see the first. There are six zones you will observe around the city area, around the market area. In every six zone, the agriculture land use will be different and the intensity of the crops will be different. Let us talk about the first zone, that is truck farming, or it is a, you can say that the dairy farming. Yes, student. So here in this figure, you will observe that the six concentrating zone that you observe around the city, around the market. This is the first, this is second, this is third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. These are the six concentrating zone of the agricultural land use you will observe around the city. So we are first, let's talk about the, this is the first zone of truck farming, or it is also known as the dairy farming. Dear student, in this first zone, you will observe the mostly the perishable commodity, the agriculture of the perishable commodity, or the perishable commodity like a fruits, like a vegetable, will be produced in that area. You know that the perishable fruits are those like to spoil, delay, decay, or become unsafe to consume if not kept refrigerated. It means what? We have to use this all the perishable food within a short time. So if you not able to send them within a short period in market, then definitely it will be useless or unsafe to consume. So therefore, this first zone will be, and one thing is very important. And to avoid the more distance, if you travel the more distance to carry out this such type of the activity, then this such type of the commodity, then definitely they will be take a much more time to reach toward the market. And during that period, definitely that perishable food will be unsafe or will be not good for the consumer. Therefore, this is a very important. And for this perishable food like fruits and vegetable, there is a good demand from the city area, because you know that in city area the consumers are more, the population is more. Therefore, there is a continuous demand for this commodity, and we cannot be avoid these things for our in our regular life. So therefore, and the basis of this experience explains this first zone that was we observe around the city. Second zone is forestry or and firewood zone. You know that this model was explained during the 1826. I am talking about that period. For the fuel purpose, the firewood was very important. Then wood was very important, and that we know that we get these woods and the forest thing from the forest. And during that period also, for the building and the other various purpose, the main resource was wood that we get from, that we were able to get from the forest. So therefore, and this is the very bulky things. If we do such type of the this activity, or we bring the area under the forest from the, away from the city, what will happen? Then we require the more transportation cost, because they are very bulky. They require the lot of bulky cost. So therefore, to avoid this transportation cost, and there is a continuous during that period, there was continuous demand for the as a fuel purpose for the forestry and the building and the other purpose, the forest wood was very important. Therefore, this was a very important activity that we around we will during that period. In his model, he explained that in the next, this is the next ring number second or zone number second here. You will observe the land, agricultural land use of forestry. I mean, the forests are here as a like a commercial use. They produce this, they planted this forest here for the commercial use. And during that period, it was the very demanded thing. Therefore, the second zone that was explained by the Vantuna, it was the forestry or the firewood zone. Next zone was zone number three, is food grain farming or intensive cultivation. And in this is the number third zone that we have. These are the complete circle you will observe here. So food grain farming and intensive cultivation. Intensive cultivation means in that period, the all the area of that region was bring by the farmer under the various crops. The main crop is rye. Rye was the main crop in Germany. Therefore, it was also very demanded. So therefore, the number third zone was the mostly dominated by the intensive agriculture, and the main crop was rye. Then he explained the ring number four or the zone number four of agriculture land use, food grain farming. The fear follow land is zero. you know that student, the uncultivated land for a certain period of time. So you know that when we cultivate the land for a continuous for a long period, then definitely the fertility of that soil, fertility of the land will going to decrease. And if you want to retain, sustain this fertility, so for that purpose, we have to keep this land for a certain period uncultivated. So that land is known as the fall land. And when we are talking about the ring number 4, that food grain farming, in that here we have the fall land 0. But what are the major crops that are cultivated, that were cultivated in that zone? It was the rye, barley, oats, and pasture. Pasture is also very important for the livestock purpose. And then we have the fallow land. Then zone number 5, that livestock ranching and the food grain farming. Here, near about the 14% area of the land was kept under the fallow land. So these were the number five. Here you will observe that near about, out of this 100, near about the 14% area or the land was under the fallow land. So for, I just mentioned that to retain the fertility of that soil or that agricultural land, the farmer was kept this land as a fallow land. And in this zone, you will observe that again the rye is main, then pasture, then here we have fallow land, potato, sweet potato. These are the important crops that were cultivated by the farmers in the zone number 5. And last we have the zone, that is the food grain farming, grazing. And here, near about the 33% area of this zone was under the fallow land. And here also, means what? The most of the land was they kept as a fallow land. And this zone was the year livestock activity was also, and food grain farming was, and grazing purposes also. For the grazing purpose, this area was used, and the most part of this area was under the pasture. So these were about the 6 zone that was explained by the Vantunan observed around the city. Let us see the figure again. So this is the full figure. Same, just I mentioned that the 6 here we have the city. There is a marketplace here, city here. Then we have the horticulture, dairy, means the perishable thing. Then here we have secondary, that forestry. Here we have the farming, crop rotation here, enclosed field here, 3 field here, and grazing is there. So these are the same. The same thing are they explained with the full figure here. So dear student, so this was about the first time when he explained his model. But when the model was explained that time, it was read by the various scholar, economists, geographer, and they criticized on that model. So after a few years, he modified his model. So let us see what was the modification. The two modification was very important. The one is the navigable rivers, meant that river when we use for the transportation purpose, water purpose. If the if there is a river and that he traveled through that plain region, that time that river's water can be used for the transportation purpose. And you know that the waterway is the cheap way of the transportation as compared to road transportation, railway transportation, and the air transportation. Therefore, if the any region have a river and that was passing through that region, so definitely that also affect on the particular transportation cost. So that was explained by the Vantunan in his model. The transport is more speedy and the cheaper than the land. And the second modification he was explained about the more, suppose a region that hinterland, isolated hinterland have a 2 marketplace, mean more than one or two, that time also we don't have the whatever the just I mentioned the agricultural land use, that type of the land use you will not observe in that area. If there's any, we have the same the major city there, the major marketplace, and suppose in nearby this market, if any other small town will be grow after a few years, then definitely it will be affect the land use of that. Here you can see, so this is the market number 1, or you can this city number 1. Here we have the city number here. You see, they are the first, third, and fourth are the separate. The both marketplace have the separate their own zone. So that type of the modification explain in his, when he modify his model, that time the Vantunan explain him. This was about the when we have the more than one marketplace in that same area, that will be that time you will observe such type of the agricultural land use. And second is very important here. See, so it was the these zones were explained by the Vantunan before his modification the model, and after the modification of it. So see, this is the river. This is a very important river, perennial river, and that is useful for the water transportation purpose. So therefore, definitely, so instead of the circular zone, here will have the, here you will observe the this type of the zones. Zones are same. There is no any what you can say the sequence is changed. Sequence will be remain same, but just the shape will be changed. So this is the, here you can see the subcenter means the other market. Just in previous slide I show the what will be what type of the agricultural land use pattern we will observe. So in this model he slightly change his model, and see, you can see the difference between the previous model and the model that was he explained after the modification. So this was the center city, so divisible rivers, the market gardening and the milk production, the firewood and the lumber production, crop farming without fall land, the crop farming follow and the pasture, three field system, livestock farming. So this was about, just I mentioned same thing are here, but just you can say, you can see the shape are change of them, but sequence are remain same. This was about the modification. Dear student, let us see the important criticism done by the various scholar, economist and the geographer. The first thing, very important, see, the assumption that there is the existence of an isolated state or and the closed economy is unrealistic in general. It may be possible during that period, it was the period of 1826, during that period at some extent it was possible, but see, it was the, I just mentioned that this model was whole based on his own data, own experience, and it was stated in the Germany. But see, nowadays it is impossible to find such type of the condition, an isolated state and the closed economy. So therefore, the most of the geographer or the economists so criticize in the first assumption, because yes, one or two may be possible, but each and every assumption, whatever explained by the Vantunan, it will be not possible to search in any place. That was the second. Third one, second is farming system is not found same everywhere in the world. Yes, this is also very important. Then measurement of the intensity and the economic rain is difficult to test and complex, yet it's very important, because you know that the transportation cost, markets cost, production cost, it will be not remain same every year. It will be changed time to time and place to place. So therefore, this is also a major criticism done by the various scholars. Then the farmer do not behave like an economic man, and the Vantuna also ignorance increasing in the production. So that is very important. So you know that the nature of the farmer is something different than the economic man, the businessman. So that time he knows always the thing about the like a commercial attitude will not be observed in his behavior. So therefore, so this is also very important criticism done by the various scholar. Then next one here, he do not consider socio-economic and the other factors of agricultural land. Yes, it is a very important, because he just mentioned about the whatever the explanation given by the Vantunan's model, that was totally depend what you just say, you just listen about the economic rate or the locational rate, and whatever the calculation, or he explained his information on the base of the market price, then production price and transport cost. But see, the other factor are very important, maybe the nature of the nature of the farming, then the input of that we require the farming, the government policy, socio-economic condition of that farmer, irrigation facility. So these all are very important when we're talking about the agricultural land use, and that was not considered by the Vantunan in his model. Next one is that the freight rate is reality is not directly proportional to distance, but it steps safe being divided into the different freight rate zones. That is also very important about the, this criticism also important about the Vantunan. And he explained without less data and was limited area. So yes, it is a very important, because whatever data he explained in his model, it was his own data, and some extent he was used the data of the some city that was located around his place. So therefore, it was not applicable all part of the world, because everywhere you will observe the something different data. So this model was depend on the limited data. So that is why this theory was rejected by the many scholar. And one thing is, he don't consider about the climatical and other factor of the production. That is very important, because you know that the climatical condition is main factor that would affect the land use pattern. So he not consider about the climatic condition, and therefore the people are rejected. But still, dear student, it was the relevance of the model, the merit of the model. I am going to explain few of them. The first time he described the pattern of land use about the agriculture system around the city. That is very important. The Wanton was the first person, the first farmer and economist. I mean, it was an unprofessional economist. He first time he explained such type of the model, therefore it is important. Then he explained the theory with help of the simple mathematical formula. You know that this formula was very simple. The common man can also calculate the economic rent and location rent. So that is why this theory is very important. Logical thinking was important and inspiring to others. When he put this thing, explain his model, publish his model, then definitely this model was read by the various scholar and the various economists. And therefore, that type of the study was starting. Even in India also, the Dr. Shafi was applied this model in the UP district of in the Aligarh district of the UP. So everywhere, so that was what that was happened. The due to this model, the people starting to research, starting to things, starting to study the agricultural land use. So this was the inspiration. So that was great goes to Wanton. He show the changes to agricultural land use pattern with help of the transparent cost. That is also important. Yes, the some model was during that period also explained by the various economists, but it was the model with help of the transportation cost he explained. So therefore, and last one, that the first theory or the model to show spatial distribution of the agricultural activity, that is very important. So definitely this was the first time this all information, this model was explained by the Wanton. So therefore, this model still today, this model is applicable. So we can also apply same model to study our city and the whatever we have the agricultural land use around the city. So that is very important. Dear student, this was the last topic of our first chapter number 2, economic activity. I hope this chapter is clear to you all. If any query, you can mail me anytime. I will provide note of the PDF form as early as possible. In our next lecture, we will start with our next chapter, that is resources. So thank you. Thank you.